heavyweight gold medal final. 201 pounds plus. There's Riddick Bowe, 21 years old from Brooklyn. Lennox Lewis, 23 from Kitchener, Ontario, Canada. He has Olympic experience, lost to Tyrell Biggs of the United States in the super heavyweight quarterfinal back in 84 in L.A. Lennox Lewis, in his last bout, advanced on a walkover. Prior to that, he came up with a knockout only 34 seconds in. And for Riddick Bowe, as we mentioned earlier, this, the toughest opponent he has ever faced. Riddick has had his ups and downs, but he has come up with a couple of stoppages and then won on points. But the problem with Riddick has been getting distracted, not concentrated. Well, Lewis has turned bouts on several occasions.
Lewis will get your attention. He punches very hard with a great deal of precision. Riddick Bowe's going to have to be on his toes, or he will be on his back very shortly.
Referee Gustav Baumgart of East Germany calling the headbutt on Bowe. Lennox Lewis, though, coming back from a broken right thumb suffered at the 88 Canada Cup in Ottawa, which hampered his training most of the summer. Coaches say that he's been emotionally down. He has not been using all his skills, may still be bothered by that broken right thumb. He has not been himself, although he did come up with that early knockout in the semifinals.
So far, he's thrown mainly his left hand, although it has been hard. Not much action thus far. Nothing significant happening with either fighter. Bowe now going into a series of combination punches, which means he's waking up. You get a wake-up call early in the first round against Lennox Lewis.
And Lewis called for pushing Bowe's head down, and then Bowe complained to the referee Baumgart, and Baumgart told him to keep quiet. And once again, a caution on Lewis.
Inside uppercut, another nice inside, another one by Bowe. Now he's punching with authority.
Riddick Bowe certainly with his attention span in the right direction in this bout. Perhaps the Roy Jones decision served as a reminder that Riddick Bowe would have to be in this one right from the start. And once again, the referee Baumgart with the caution on Bowe for a butt.
Well, I think that Jones decision spurred on Maynard. I think it's spurring on Bowe to close the show in fashion. Remember, Jones goes down with Remember the Alamo here because these guys are inspired.
In his previous bouts, Bowe came in with that left hand down, almost a one flap down out of the pages of Jeffrey Leonard of the Milwaukee Brewers. He did not take his previous opponent seriously. Not the case here, though, with Canada's Lennox Lewis.
Lewis fighting in a rather lazy fashion. He's not really that sharp. Bowe is much sharper, and he's punching two and three, scoring blows at a time, not neglecting the body. So, however slow this is, Bowe has got the edge on aggression and points for punches landed.
Bowe just missing with that right hand. Lennox Lewis does look on the lethargic side. 10 seconds remaining in this first round. And there is a warning. Another caution on Bowe for a headbutt. And that is number three, so he has lost a point on the scorecard.
Oh, my.
And a good right hand from Lennox Lewis. That is it for round one.
Big disadvantage Riddick Bowe put himself into with his headbutt. Now, you see, that's a headbutt only in the Olympics. It did not hit heads. He just went under the punch. Now, that's really called very strangely, I think. And where was Baumgart where we needed him in the last fight where there was nothing but butting going on?
According to Counterpunch, Bowe with the decisive edge in terms of punches landed. Riddick Bowe in the white trunks, youngest of 14 children out of Brooklyn, from the Brownsville section of Brooklyn, a four-time New York City Golden Gloves champion. And Lennox Lewis stepping it up here as he comes out of the second round, and that will be a standing eight. So Lewis turning it up. His coaches were very dissatisfied with his first round performance, and they were screaming at him in the corner, and Lewis has come out inspired.
Well, Lewis woke up with that one good shot. Baumgarten becoming a factor in this fight. One more headbutt, and that's a point off the next one.
Another standing eight.
I can't believe this.
And the Koryan. The fight is over. Gustav Baumgart of East Germany says it is all over. And the winner is Lennox Lewis of Canada. He felt that Bo had had enough. We have seen some quickie stoppages in the higher weight classifications.
Well, maybe it's a bad day for the American team, but I cannot agree with that at all. I thought Baumgarten was an unnecessary intruding factor. I thought those headbutts that were called were gratuitous at best, and I thought the stoppage was very strange. I mean, very doubtful. We're not in there with the boxer, but from here, it did not look like Riddick Bowe was in any trouble, nor that the punch was particularly effective.
On the other hand, he was being thrashed pretty good, and it's a judgment call on the part of the referee, Gustav Baumgart. I did not see any great dissatisfaction from Riddick Bowe's corner. Ken Adams seemed to accept it. The stoppage coming at 43 seconds of round number two. No argument from Riddick Bowe as he stopped by Lennox Lewis. He did take a pounding, and Baumgart decided that is it. The stoppages in the heavier ranks have come very quickly, as we have seen.
Well, they're heavy punches, and as I say, and I don't hesitate to give credit to the referee. He's in there with the boxer. He knows what's happening to his condition, his eyes, and so forth. We don't, so let's give him the benefit of the doubt. But it is for the gold, and that requires a little bit more patience.
So Lennox Lewis has won the gold in the super heavyweight division. We'll be back after these messages. Let's go to Wally.
Riddick, did you feel the fight was stopped too soon?
Well, I thought he was very premature in his decision, because again, in the first round, I hit him with some pretty good shots, never even gave him an eight count.
Yeah, but when after the first standing eight, you didn't really put up very much resistance, so were you surprised that the referee stepped in at that point?
Precisely, because I really wasn't. He hit me with a good two shots, I got to admit, but I was okay. Clearly, I was even talking to him.
Here's the end of the fight. We're going to take a look at it now. Tell me what's happening.
Well, he hit me with a good right hand.
How badly are you hurt here?
Well, I was shaking up pretty much, but I didn't think it was enough for him to stop the fight. Because I've seen guys get practically killed in the ring. You know, take Todd Porter, for instance. He had a pretty hard fight. He was bleeding and what have you. And he got dropped. The ref didn't stop his fight.
And yet you didn't protest very much when the fight was stopped. Why was that?
Well, I started to, but I said to myself, what sense is it make? And then the coaches told me to be cool, so I guess I had to leave it at that.
Riddick, you've had kind of an up-and-down Olympics. There have been times when you've looked lethargic and other times when you've looked pretty explosive. Overall, are you disappointed with what you've done here?
No, not at all, especially in the last fight, because I was just really getting into the groove of things, and I really wanted to show Dr. Ferdy Pacheco that my head really wasn't in the clouds.
What will you do about turning pro?
Well, I'm contemplating with myself. I'm just going to see what's going to happen from now on.
Okay, Riddick Bowe, a knockout victim here in the second round of the super heavyweight final. Now back to Mark.
Alvin.